Hello, we will talk about the Zanes and Lorentzes. We are Kai Student taking the material characteristic lecture. Firstly, this presentation talks about XAS and Lorentzes and difference between Zanes and XAPs. Then we focused on Zanes and Lorentzes and applications. XAS is X-ray absorption spectroscopy. This analysis method is similar to UVBs and XPS. XAS analysis can sensitively determine the local geometric and electronic structure of materials. And this experiment is performed at synchrotron facilities because it needs an intense and tunable X-ray source. XAS has advantage of sensitivity and it can be performed with various sample state, gas and liquid and solid state. Let's simply compare to other analysis principles. Firstly, UVBs use UV and visible light source for absorption spectrum. Absorption is occurred by electron excitation from valence band to conduction bands. And XPS use an X-ray light source targeting the core electrons. XPS measure the kinetic energy of photoelectron produced by X-ray absorption. XAS is similar to XPS in that it uses X-ray, and it is similar to UV in that it measures the absorption spectrum. Therefore, the XAS is called inertial spectroscopy. A monochromatic tunable X-ray source is required to measure the absorption spectra at various wavelengths. In Korea, it can be measured through Pohang accelerators. So through the X-ray absorption spectra analysis of core electron, we can see the direction of the chemical bonding and surface mercury. The XAS can be divided into two modes depending on the wavelengths. One is Zanes and the other is XAPs. Zanes are X-ray absorption near edge structure and are the same as NEPSAPs, near edge X-ray absorption fine structure. XAPs is extended X-ray absorption fine structure. XAPs are mainly used to analyze distance between atoms, and we will focus on Zanes and Lorentzes. Zanes, like its name, is a method of analyzing about 50 electron volt near absorption threshold peak. The finding energy of core electron is determined mainly by molecules. Carbon mainly has peaked at 285 electron volt, and nitrogen mainly has peaked at 405 electron positions.
Zanes analysis mainly use X-ray obtained from radiation accelerator. Pohang Accelerator Lab, PLS, is a representative radiation accelerator equipped with a beamline facility capable of Zanes analysis in Korea. The picture on the left is the beamline map of PLS and Zanes analysis impossible on 10D beamlines. The picture on the right is a picture of 10D beamlines. The photon energy by the incident X-ray excited core electrons to the continuum state above the vacuum level or to the unoccupied electron orbit below the vacuum level, that is the liberal state. And the hole created by the escape of electrons is filled with other electrons of the higher shell, and energy is released at this time. The released energy is transferred to another electron and released the electron to the outside of the material, which is the main mechanism by which electrons are released outside the material over decay. Alternatively, the release energy is not transferred to other electrons, but is emitted in the form of photon to generate fluorescence. When the incident X-ray energy is greater than the binding energy, there is a sharp increase in absorption. Interference appears between the emitted photoelectron wave and the photoelectron wave refracted back by backscattering by colliding with electrons belonging to the surrounding atom. As a result, this interference at the absorbing atom will vary with energy, causing the oscillation. There are several methods for measuring the absorption of X-ray in Jeans analysis. Depending on the type of particle used for measurement, there are an electron yield mode and a fluorescence yield mode that use light emitted from the sample during absorption of incident X-ray. In addition, there is a transmission mode in which the intensity of the X-ray passing through the sample is measured before and after passing, and the amount of absorption is directly measured by the difference. The thickness of the sample is less than 100 nanometer, and this is the most used method. The electron yield mode is again divided into total electron yield, partial electron yield, and Auger electron yield. Total electron yield is a method of detecting electrons or of energy emitted from a sample. Not only photoelectrons by Auger electrons and photoemission, but also photoelectrons emitted by inelastic scattering inside the sample are detected. In the Auger electron yield, photoelectrons are detected only in the limited and narrow energy range around the Auger peak, where Auger electrons are detected. In partial electron yield, photoelectrons generated by photoemission are excluded and the spectrum is measured. In this mode, a grid made of beta is placed on the front of the electron detector and a retardation vortex is applied to the grid. As a result, photoelectrons with low energy are removed by the grid before reaching the detector, and photoelectrons emitted by photoemission are suppressed from being detected. The Auger electron yield mode usually shows information within a depth of 1 nanometer from the sample surface, and the partial electron yield mode shows the information by controlling the depth of sampling from 2 nanometer to 10 nanometer from the sample surface. The total electron yield mode can measure depths of tens of nanometer. The experimental setup of fluorescent yield mode is as follows. The information of the incident X-ray is I sub 0, and the information of the X-ray passing through the sample is I sub 1. After that, it passes through the reference sample once again, and the information of the subsequent X-ray is I sub 2. The reason for passing through the reference sample once again is to normalize in data analysis, which will be explained later. The fluorescence photon is detected as I sub F in a separate detector. The following figure is the experimental setup of transmission mode. It is almost the same as the previous slide. The region of the reference sample is also to normalize.
Last of all, the transmission mode, which is the most common, analyzes the energy of the transmitted beam through the sample. Because forward scattering has the highest intensity, the transmitted beam also has the highest intensity of all, which is an advantage of this analysis. In this case, we use data from I0, I1 and I2 for each the sample and the reference. Zane's data can be divided into largely three regions. The lowest energy region, which is before the highest peak, is called the pre-edge peak. This peak comes from the energy difference of the electron excitation to the unoccupied states. On a higher energy level, the highest peak, called the edge peak, is observed. And this peak corresponds to the ionization energy of the target atom. Finally, the Zane's peak comes from the energy oscillation from the multiple scatterings.
From each region of the data, we can acquire different kinds of information. Since the pre-edge peak is formed by electronic transitions to empty bound states, we can acquire information of the local geometry around the absorbing atom, the oxidation state of the atom, and the bonding characteristics. From the edge peak, which comes from the ionization of the atom, we can also obtain the oxidation state and the shift of this peak to higher energy states for the increase in the oxidation states. Last of all, from the Zanes region, formed by multiple scattering, we can obtain the atomic positions of the neighboring atoms, interatomic distances, and bond angle, which all wraps up to the geometric structure around the target atom. The intensity of the pre-edge peak changes along the coordination number difference of the target atom. For a octahedral coordination, no mixing of the 3D and 4P orbitals are allowed, and the electrons can excite only to the D orbital, which leads to low intensity. But when the octahedral is a bit distorted, little mixing of in the 3D and 4P orbitals is allowed, and electron excitation can happen to 4P orbitals too, and intensity is slightly larger. When the coordination is tetrahedral, hybridization of the 3D and 4P orbitals occur, and electrons can easily excite to both 3D and 4P orbitals, leading to the highest intensity of the pre-edge peak. The following graph is edge peak of manganese ion having each positive 2, 3, 4 charges. And as we can see from the data, as the oxidation state increases, the edge peak shifts to the higher energy region. From now, we will talk about the data processing of Zanes. Using the data from the transition mode, we can graph a plot by absorption energy and its intensities by subtracting the log of I1 and I0. After this process, we have to subtract the pre-edge because this intensity comes from the absorption due to other edges. And finally, we normalize the subtracted data with the difference of the pre-edge line and the post-edge line, which stands for the absolute energy of the used initial beam. By doing this, we can normalize the data for different incident beam intensities. With the normalized data, we can fit the data and compare the intensities, the energy, and the number of absorption features with the database, and from that we can obtain the information we want.
Zanes analysis used the PDD data of the feed. Through the decomposition process, the composition ratio of materials or oxidation number of atoms can be measured. As shown in the data reference table, same carbon peak from 1s to 5-star, but slightly different location depending on surrounding moleculars. And we can accurately estimate the condition and composition of material by this peak decomposition process. The most powerful thing about Zanes is it can be measured the orientation of moleculars. It is possible to measure the directionality of chemical bonds in molecular through polarized X-ray light. If the polarized X-ray light is set according to the angle, and the absorption intensities are changed. In a molecular, the bonding direction and the direction of bonding orbital are related. The sigma bonding orbital is parallel to the single and double bonds, and the phi bonding orbital is perpendicular to the bonding. Therefore, when the X-ray are investigated with varying incident angles, absorption varies depending on the orientation of the orbital in the molecular. The paper reference showed the most absorption when the angle of incident light is perpendicular to the direction of bonding, and the intensity is proportional to the square of the cosine theta, and the result is agreed with the simulation result. changes are contributing to the research development related to the direction of moleculars. Firstly, change analysis was used the polymer direction on the surface because the direction of polymer affects conductivity of the PLED. Secondly, DNA orientation could contribute to the future biosensor efficiency, and things could be used to detect it. Recently, sense analysis was used to determine the active site of catalyst. The sensitivity of sense data can support active site determination. Although synchrotron is not common equipment, sense analysis will become increasingly important. It will be essential analysis in measuring surface chemical state. That's all for sense presentation. Thank you.